I'll show you how to go from the Cloudways homepage to a fully business-ready website with a domain name, SSL encryption, a fully custom business email, and every best server configuration practice in just one video. You can follow along completely free of charge without even having a credit card because Cloudways does offer a free trial. Just make sure to click the link in the description together with the code Emit.Reviews and fill in your details to open up the account. Next, you'll need to verify your account. For this, you'll only need a phone number and an email address. After verification, you'll need to choose what type of software you want for your server to use. We'll go with WordPress for this tutorial. You can name your server and app whatever you want. It doesn't matter, it's just for your internal view. Now, the important choices are here. You have several servers provided to go for. They all come in different price range and different power levels. To start with, even the 1 GB options are plenty. My favorite is the DigitalOcean 1 GB plan, but the high-speed version of it, coming in at $14 a month if you do decide to pay later. Cloudways then will configure your server completely automatically. You can see the estimated time before it's finished here, and once it's finished, this is how it looks. You can reach your WordPress control panel right here, and your WordPress login credentials can be copied and pasted from the main dashboard to reach your WordPress dashboard. So currently, this is how the website looks. It's just a default template. However, we can change it quite easily to something better. Navigate back to your WordPress dashboard, hover over Appearance, and click Themes. Next, look for the Add New Theme button. While there are a lot of free themes here, I personally really like Bloxy because it comes with great looking and, more importantly, responsive and fast pre-made designs. So I'll be going with that, and I highly recommend you do that as well. Now, after you activate your new theme, you'll see this pop-up for the Bloxy Companion plugin. Install and activate that as well. And here are the main advantages of themes like Bloxy. If you click on Starter Site, you can actually get fully designed websites that you'll be able to edit any way you like, completely free of charge. But while there are free variants, there are paid ones as well. You can filter out the free ones by clicking here and choosing free. There is a good variety to choose from, but you can get a more in-depth look by clicking preview next to the design. It'll take you to the demo website to showcase how your website would look if you would use this pre-made design. For this tutorial, I'll go with this yoga-themed one. To get it working, all you need to do is click on import, then tick the circle next to the child theme and click next. For the editor, choose Elementor and install everything. The nice thing about this is that the installation will load all of the demo files and demo layouts onto your WordPress site, making sure you don't really have to style and design anything yourself. After the installation is done, you can click on View Site to see how the final product looks. Now, I'll quickly go over how to edit your website, but if you already know how Elementor works or just want to continue the Cloudways server setup, skip to this part of the video. Now, to edit any page on this template to your needs, all you have to do is click the Edit with Elementor button. Once inside editing mode, you can click on any element you want to change and a sidebar will appear. For example, if you click on text elements, you can change the text right here. Now, to change the font, color, or anything else is in the style tab. As the name suggests, it allows you to style that element. For example, if I click on typography, I can change the font size to better fit my new design. And finally, in the advanced tab, you can work on the spacing for the elements. If you would like to increase the gap, I can just unlink the values and add 20 pixels to the bottom of this element, creating a 20 pixel large gap. Images can be edited the same way. Just click on them and you'll see the same content, style, and advanced bar for this element. Here, I can change the default picture used by uploading one of my own images or choosing another one of the pre-made ones, like I'm doing here. Now it's a little bit too big. To scale it down, we can use the Style tab and change the Width value. Now, keep in mind that Elementor works with box within a box within a box within a box principle. Here you can see all of the different containers, and since this portion of our design is located in the top container, we can navigate to it and increase the margin to create more of a gap or padding to extend our section and make it look a bit nicer. And once you find the design you like, don't forget to click on the update button to save your changes once in a while. Now let's move on to editing the menu area, because you can't change it via Elementor. There's a separate WordPress dashboard exclusively for that purpose. To reach it, navigate to your base website by deleting all of the stuff before the slash wp-admin stuff. And you'll see a button that says customize. Click on it. As you can see, here you can select and change the menu design and content. For example, switch some of the elements around or straight up delete the button you don't want, as well as style the elements you choose to keep, like this call us button. But keep in mind, this is only for the Bloxy theme. It might be different if you use a different theme. But what's the same for all WordPress websites is, if you would navigate a bit back, you would find more options, and most importantly, the menu option. This allows you to change the text of your existing menu items, add completely new menu items, and select where they link to. This can be inside your own page or outside, for example, google.com. And that's pretty much how editing the website works. You just have to do this for each element you want to edit. And once you've finished tweaking the design, you'll notice that your website has this weird name. If you want to change this to something more appropriate, like catshowers.com, you would need to own the name catshowers.com and then connect that domain to your Cloudways server via a record and a CNAME record. Sounds complicated, but trust me, it's really just copy and pasting some value. So navigate back to your Cloudways control panel and click on Domain Management. As you can see, this weird one is currently our primary domain. So click on Add Domain and type in your name that you want to use for this website. Keep in mind that this has to be a domain you already own. Cloudways does not sell domains directly, so you would have to purchase this name separately somewhere else, or have purchased it somewhere in the past. I personally buy my domains at Hostinger, so you can grab any name you want for like $10 a year on average, but it doesn't have to be Hostinger. If you bought yours somewhere else, it doesn't matter, it all works the same. Once the name is added here, navigate to your domain name provider. If you're on Hostinger, it can be found by logging in, then going into Domains, choosing your domain name, and clicking Manage next to that domain. Finally, you'll see a button called DNS/nameservers on the left. To point your domain to Cloudways, find the current A record. It's always an IP address and looks like a bunch of numbers. Go back to Cloudways and navigate to Access Details. Copy your public IP address and simply edit the A record with the Cloudways IP address instead. That's it. But keep your DNS records open, we'll need them a little bit later as well. But keep in mind, this takes a little bit of time to take effect. So after 10 minutes or so, your domain name should lead to the Cloudways server and display your website correctly. The problem now is that you'll get this security warning, and if you bypass it, it would still state that your website is not secure. What's up with that? Well, we don't have an SSL certificate installed for this domain name, so all of the information that's coming through your website is not encrypted, meaning anyone could potentially take a look and steal it. To install an SSL certificate, navigate back to Cloudways control panel and click on the SSL certificate button. Type in your email address as well as your website name. Now select Apply Wildcard. This will automatically issue certificates for any subdomains you might use in the future. But as you can see here, we'll need to add one more record to our DNS area called a CNAME record. That's why I said keep it open previously. So let's go back to Hostinger or your domain name provider. Instead of editing an existing record, we'll be creating a new one. So choose CNAME from the drop-down menu. For the name, copy this section here. Don't forget that you do need the underscore as well. And for the target, copy this section. Finally, click Add Record, go back to Cloudways, click on Verify DNS, and if it's all good, then install the certificate. Once installed, you can refresh your page and boom, The log now shows no errors and your website is encrypted via an SSL certificate. Next, we'll add a CDN, making sure our website is distributed on servers all across the world, making our global loading speed a lot faster. Cloudways offers to do this for you for $4.99, but I'll show you how to do it manually for free. First of all, navigate to cloudflare.com and sign up for a free account. Then click on Add Website or Application and enter your website name. Choose the free plan again. Now, Cloudflare will do a quick scan of your DNS records. Just wait for that to finish and then continue. Now, we'll edit our DNS settings once again. So copy your assigned name server from Cloudflare, go to Hostinger or your domain name provider and click on Change Name Servers. Finally, just copy and paste the two values in here and save the changes. As you can see, we can no longer edit our DNS here. We'll have to do it through Cloudflare for all future customization because now Cloudflare acts like a middleman, redirecting our traffic to servers all across the world instead of one singular location. But just like any DNS change, it takes about 10 minutes for the changes to take effect. You'll know that it's done once you click this button and see the green check mark. Nothing else needs to be done with Cloudflare for now, but keep it open because we'll be editing our DNS area one more time in the future. Now we'll need to install Redis onto our server to significantly improve the performance of it. Start by going to your WordPress dashboard and navigating to Plugins, then add new plugin, type in File Manager and install this Advanced File Manager plugin. Now we're able to edit the code of our website straight from the WordPress dashboard, no need to migrate anywhere else. The first thing you'll want to do is find a file named wp-config, right-click it and edit it. Scroll down till you see this section called Authentication, Unique Keys and Salts. Paste in this line that I'll leave in the description right here and type in your website name instead of yoursite.com. Finally, click on Save and Close. Then navigate back to Cloudways and look for an option called My Servers. Click on your server and go into Manage Services. Redis should be running already, but if it's not, click on Enable. And since Redis is now activated on our server, we can activate it on our website as well. Go into WordPress, hover over your settings and click on Object Cache. All you need to do here is enable cache, the status should show connected, and drop-in should be valid. This means Redis is now working correctly and your server and website is a lot faster. And while we're working on the performance of our site, let's also go into the Breeze plugin that comes pre-installed with Cloudways. Here, we'll be able to further tweak the performance and make our website even more faster and well optimized. First things first, mobile cache is disabled by default. To activate it, you'll need to go into your Cloudways dashboard, navigate to your application and go into Application Settings. Here you'll find an option to activate device detection. Once it's enabled, you can go back to WordPress, refresh the page and mobile cache should be active, making website mobile website visitors much happier. While you're here, I also recommend you activate lazy load images, HTML minify, CSS minify, JS minify, and delay all JavaScript, then save changes. As you can see, our website is pretty darn fast right now, loading various pages almost instantly. That's the power of Cloudways and all of the optimization work that we have done. Okay, at this point, we already have a perfectly good website, but it's missing some quality of life features like a professional email box and an SMTP server for smoother email delivery. Let's start with the custom SMTP server. Once again, navigate to My Servers and click the SMTP option and choose your own SMTP. As for the provider, we'll go with Other as we're going to use a completely free option. That free option is called Brevo. You can sign up for a free account, fill out your information. No payment info is needed, just a mobile phone number once again. So let's continue with the free plan. All you need from here is the SMTP and API information to copy and paste into Cloudways. So let's do that right now. For the password, you can find it hidden here. Once it's done, you can send a test email for yourself. Make sure the sender email is the one you used when signing up for Brevo. If everything is working correctly, you'll get the test email looking like this. And at this point, we're only missing one thing, a professional email box to go with our SMTP server. So you could send and receive emails from an address that looks like this instead of a generic Gmail one. Cloudways offered this feature, but it costs $1 a month per email box. And of course, me being me, I'll show you how to get up to 5 email boxes completely free of charge. Now, for the final time, we'll be using another third-party service called Zoho Mail. So sign up for a free account any way you want, and I'll guide you through the setup process. First of all, we'll want to create a domain-based email account, and we'll try the free option. Next, you'll need to type in your website name and the rest of this information. Now, you'll need to prove that you do in fact own this website name. So click on Configure Manually. As you can see, we'll need to add in another DNS record, except this time we won't be going through Hostinger because we can't anymore. We'll do it by going through Cloudflare. Navigate to DNS, then Settings. Here you'll be able to add a new record, so just choose the TXT type and copy paste the rest of the information from Zoho. And then you just verify. Don't worry if it says verification failed. This is a DNS change, it takes some time, so give it about 1 minute and then try it again. It takes a little bit of time to take effect. Okay, once verified, you can actually start creating your free professional emails. I'll go with info@emitreviews.xyz. You can add up to 5 users here if you like. I'll stay with 1 for this tutorial. To finish up, click this button right here. We don't need any groups, we just continue with DNS mapping. And this is where we'll do our final DNS customization. Since we need to link this email address with our domain name and our server respectively, the process is just like before. We get a set of records we'll need to add. For MX records, I already had 2 left over from Hostinger, so I'll either need to delete them or just change them to be the Zoho ones instead. To edit a record, just click on the edit button and change the value. If you didn't have any MX records, you would need to create 3 new ones, but since in my case I already edited 2 existing ones, I'll just need to make 1 new one. And oops, it needed to be priority 50, not 30, so I'll change that real quick. As for the SPF value, I also had it left over from Hostinger, so I can either delete it and create a new one or just edit the existing one. I'll go with the second option. And finally, for the DKIM record, I'll just create a new TXT record with the specified values as I have no record of this kind to edit. And that's it. Now just click on verify a couple of times to see if you've done everything correctly. For me, it took about 30 seconds for the SPF record to catch on and update. But once it's verified, you can go straight to your Zoho email box and enjoy your professional email addresses. So use this inbox when sending or receiving your professional emails. Cool. That's it. Now we have a fully functioning Cloudways website with all of the bells and whistles. Good luck, future webmaster, and I'll see you around.